It looks like we are live. All right then. So, get yourself into a position where you've got room around you. And what we're gonna do is get some big arm rolls. Big arm rolls, big arm rolls. There we go, big arm rolls, all the way around. Wicked, wicked. We go back, 5 seconds, and then we're gonna go forward, okay? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then we go forward. Then we go forward. Big arm rolls forward. Awesome. 5 seconds, we're gonna have our hands on our hips, and we're gonna roll those hips. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands on the hips, you're gonna roll. Roll the hips round, any way that you want. Any way that you want, roll them hips round. Awesome, and then we go 5 seconds the other way. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then we go the other way. All the way round, all the way round. Awesome, great work, wicked. And we are going to start squatting, partial squatting. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, partial squats. Nothing too deep, partial squats. Nothing too deep, awesome work. And in 5 seconds, we're gonna go a bit deeper. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're gonna go deep, deep squats. Deep squats, deep squats. And in 5 seconds, from the squatting, we're gonna lift the knee up to the elbow. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We squat, lift the knee up to the elbow. Squat, lift the knee up to the elbow. Get rhythmic, get that rhythm going, get that flow going. Everything with flow, movement. And we're gonna do this for the next 5 seconds. After that, we're gonna go into front partial lunges. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We go out, partial lunge, and then we alternate. Partial lunge, alternate. Partial lunge, alternate. Wicked. 5 seconds, little run on the spot. Little run on the spot, little run on the spot. And one, wicked. Great work, awesome work. I know it's cutting out. Are you all right there, Liz? All right, thanks. All right then, cool. All right, we've got a welcome. I've got Mads here and Liz, you're here. All right then, so. Okay, the first thing that we are going to need are weights. So if you get your weights. And we will go into bicep curls. We're gonna go into a long ass round. And we're just gonna keep on going with the flow. The first thing we're gonna do is bicep curling, okay? Get the weights in your hands, either side of your body, elbows kept to your sides, and we bicep curl. We go in, bicep curling. Get the arms proper pumped. Wicked, nice. And we wanna be strict, tight with the form, with the body. Brilliant, brilliant. And we are gonna convert it to a shoulder press. So it will be combined with a bicep curl to a shoulder press. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bicep curl, shoulder press. Bicep curl, shoulder press. All combined. Bicep curl, shoulder press. Keep the elbows close by the side and then launch the arms up. Launch them up. Wicked work, wicked work. And what we are gonna do in 5 seconds is have a bicep curl. We are then gonna squat. And then as we come up, we're gonna launch the shoulder press. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bicep curl, squat, launch the shoulder press. Bicep curl, squat, launch the shoulder press. Bicep curl, squat, launch the shoulder press. We're gonna do this for the next 10 seconds, and then we're gonna go into alternate lunges. One leg goes out, comes back in, the other leg goes out. Alternate in the lunges. In 3, 2, 1, we go. Lunge forward, hold the weights by your side. Alternate your legs. Wicked, great lunging. When you do lunge, make sure that the trailing knee is not touching the floor. Get your shoulders pinned back. Get your lower spine nicely curved in. Make that stride wide on the lunges. And in 5 seconds, we are gonna add a reverse lunge with the same leg that you are starting off with. 5, 4, 3, 2, One, and then we come back. Reverse lunge. Come to the middle. Alternate the legs. Go right back. Reverse lunge. Come back to the middle. And what we want is no stopping. From the front lunge to the reverse lunge. Come out, front lunge, reverse lunge. Wicked work. Forward lunge, reverse lunge. Come to the middle, alternate legs. Wicked work, brilliant work, awesome. In 5 seconds time, we're gonna drop the dumbbells and we are gonna get on the bench, on the seat, and we are gonna sit down with our hands either side of our hips and we will go into dips in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We are going to sit, hands either side of our hips, slip the bum off, and we go into dips. Tricep dips. Awesome work. Nice and deep. Get the elbows in line with the shoulders. Keep your back solid. Keep it very, very close to the bench that you are now dipping on. Wicked work. And in 5 seconds, we're going to elevate one leg and we're going to go into pistol dips. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift one leg right up and we want to go pistol dipping. Keep that leg elevated. Keep it up, keep it tight, and keep those arms proper working. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Get the other leg up. Get the other leg up. And we are pistol dipping. Great work, great work, awesome work. In 5 seconds, both feet planted, coming up, holding in a glute bridge position. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Both feet planted, dip, glute bridge hold, glute bridge hold. And then we go down, and then again up, glute bridge hold. Hold that bridge, tighten those abs. Squeeze those glutes, feel those hamstrings, keep it all tight for the next 5, 4, 3, 2. Well done, well done. Round one, and get yourselves a drink. You have me screaming even though you are within 3 millimeters of distance. Nick, Nick. Open that wide. There you go. That's got me wide. That's it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. That's what happens. Well done, Liz. Well done. Well done, everyone. Right then, the next thing that we are going to do, next round, is going to be pure kettlebell. So grab a kettlebell. We're going to go into a series of movements. Swings, cleans, all kinds of good stuff. Right then. So the first thing that we are going to do with these kettlebells is we are going to put them on the floor and we are going to straddle them wide, straddle them wide. And we are going to hip hinge down with one arm, with one hand. You are going to get the kettlebell and you're going to lift it up for a squat lift, a squat lift. You're going to put it down, you're going to stand up without the kettlebell, and then you're going to grab it with the other hand. So we are now going to be sequencing from moving, alternating one arm to the other. Two squats for every one hold. 3, 2, 1, and we go. We grab the kettlebell. We squat lift up or deadlift up. We put the kettlebell on the floor and then we naturally come back up again without the kettlebell. And then we grab the kettlebell with the opposite arm. There we go. Brilliant work, organizing. There you go, brilliant work. Coordination is of paramount importance right now. Keep this superb functional movement going. And in 10 seconds, starting from now, we are gonna grab the kettlebell with one arm and not let it go. And we are gonna follow through from the squat lift to the upright row, one arm. 3, 2, 1, squat lift, upright row. Then we squat down, we deadlift, upright row. Squat down, deadlift, upright row. Squat lift, there we go. Good work, great work. When you do come up for the upright row, make sure the kettlebell is very, very close to the body.
Make sure your elbow is higher than your wrist on every single rep that you do. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're gonna change arms, change arms, change arms. Squat lift, upright row, elbow higher than the wrist. Everywhere in the movement, you are making sure that you are precise, concise with the levers, the mechanics, the mechanics of your body. Hip hinging, knee flexing, keeping your knees in line with your toes. Hip hinging so your lower back is nicely, naturally curved. After 5 seconds, we're gonna grab the kettlebell with two hands and we're gonna start swinging eye level. 3, 2, 1. We start swinging eye level. Hip hinging, swinging eye level. Hip hinging, swinging high level. There we go. Awesome work. Brilliant work. Awesome. We are now in 5 seconds gonna be lifting this kettlebell even higher, swinging it even higher to sky level. 5, 4, 3, 2, sky level. Put the brakes on, go right through the legs. Swing it right up, sky level. Put the brakes on, and then you are now swinging to the sky, sky level. After 5 seconds, we are gonna combine eye level, sky level. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we go. Eye level, sky level. Get that movement going. Eye level, sky level. Brilliant work, eye level, sky level. We're gonna do this for another 10 seconds, and then we are gonna feed the kettlebell through our legs and go into a figure eight core functional movement. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One arm, feed the kettlebell through the legs. Feed that kettlebell through the legs. Grab the kettlebell on the other side, behind your body. Lift your upper body up using your core function. Wicked work. Come right up. Swing that kettlebell right round. Get a nice swooping dip like a roller coaster. Right through them legs. Right through them legs. And what we are going to do in 5 seconds is place the kettlebell on one side of our feet, whichever foot that you choose. Place the kettlebell very close to that foot on the floor. And then you're going to swing diagonally all the way across the body. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You place the kettlebell down, flex up the knee, swing right up and protect the kettlebell so that it doesn't over swing over the opposite side of your body. Core functional. Feel it in the obliques. Movement. Feel it in the obliques. One arm. Swing. Slice it down very close to your foot. Create that awareness. Get that urgency to create the agency and make sure that you are swinging with one side of your body being the dominant factor, the other side protecting. We've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Swap. Swap sides. Swap sides. Swap sides. We're gonna flow. All about the flow. One side of the body low to the other side of the body high. One side of the body low to the other side of the body high. Wicked work. Wicked work. 10 seconds. One arm clean. 10 seconds. One arm clean. Kettlebell goes on the floor. You're gonna squat lift up. Upright row. Combine it with the sweep at the top for the clean. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We go down, clean it up, and then we return it. Clean it up, then we return it. Snatch that kettlebell up. Clean that kettlebell up. One arm, there we go. And in 5 seconds, we're gonna swap arms. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We swap arms. Clean that kettlebell. Upright row it, very close to the body. Get the elbow really high. Squat lift, use your quads, use your hands, use your glutes. Use your stomach. There we go. Swing it right over. We're going to swap hands in 5 seconds. And we are going to go with a press on top of the clean with a squat. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's going to be big. We clean. We squat. We press. We sweep down. We clean. We squat. We press. We're going to sweep down. This is massive. Wicked, wicked concentration. Wicked work. Well done. Wicked day, wicked. Nice. Squat deep, ladies. Squat deep. And clean it. Press it. 5 seconds. Swapping arms. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We swap arms. We squat. We press. We clean. We squat. We press. There we go. We return. We clean. We squat. We press. And then we return. There you go. Another 10 seconds. And round 2 would have been done. We have got another 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Well done. Well done. Well done. Awesome work. Awesome work. Brilliant. Brilliant. Hydrate. Get some air. Get some air, damn boy.
Looking for an easy means of escape.
Right, the next thing you will need is band, if you have it. So you want to wrap a band around the legs, underneath the knees is where we want this band to go. We're going to go into side lunges with squats. So, before we start, you're going to get a little bit of demonstration. Put your band on and make sure that your band is firm, tight. With one leg, you're going to go out. Then you're going to squat, and then you're going to bring the other leg in. Squat again, and then that leg that you brought in, it now goes out. So we're going to do a 4-squat sequence where only one leg is moving at the time. So when you are ready, this band is super tight. When you are ready, we're going to go in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One leg goes out. We squat. When you do squat, make sure that your knee is not buckling. So one leg goes out, you squat. One leg goes in, you squat. And then the opposite happens. One leg goes out, you squat. The one leg follows through, you then squat again. And then you alternate the sides that you're going on. So keep this movement strict, tight. Make sure that when you are squatting, you are flaring your knees so that you are activating your glutes more than you would ever realize. All about that knee position when you squat. Get those glutes proper burning. We have got another 5 seconds for this one. We are going to drop the band and we are going to go into natural air squats. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We drop the band right off and we go into air squats. Air squats. Air squats. There we go. And we're going to bring the cardio functionality back in. So after 5 seconds from the count that I will start, we are going to go into squat jumps in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We squat, jump, squat, jump, squat, jump. Wicked work. Squat, jump, squat, jump. 10 seconds squat jumps and then back into normal air squats. We've got another 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back into air squats. Back into air squats. Feeling that blood flow in a completely different manner. Wicked work. Deep breaths in. They will work. They will work. Control your breath and you are controlling your body. Controlling your body, you are controlling your muscles. Controlling your muscles, you are going into shift mode. Wicked work. After 5 seconds, holding our body upright, on the bench like a plank, because we're going to get into planks. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we are firm handed on the bench. Keep your backs solid as if you had a spirit level, a massive spirit level from the top of your head to your tailbone, and you are dead, dead straight. Keep your toes planted, keep your arms firm, get your shoulders to be directly over your wrist, keep your stomach nice and tight, and in 5 seconds, you're gonna lift one leg up in the air, so we go into the three-legged squat. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lift one leg up in the air, that foot that you've got up in the air, make sure that you are pointing it to the floor. Get the glutes proper, solid, tight. Stomach, again, tight. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Put the foot down and lift the other foot up. Lift the other foot up. Really contract the glutes. Contract the glutes. Wicked work, wicked work. We've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And put your feet down, plank and press up. Plank and press up. When you come up to the starting position, just hold the plank for a couple of seconds and then go back down for the press up. Wicked work, wicked work. If you cannot do this with your body being stable, with your feet on the floor, then put your knees on the floor and all is good. You have no judgment of yourself because it is all about you. Express the uniqueness of you. We are gonna hold the plank for another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna get up and we are gonna starch up, starch up, starch up. There we go. Get that blood proper flowing all over the body. All that static is now flow. There is no friction, it is frictionless. Get this body functional, moving, shifting. After 5 seconds, putting our hands back on the bench, going into mountain climbers. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mountain climbers, mountain climbers. Let's go. On your tippy toes, on your tippy toes. Get your knees right up. Get your pace going. It's all about your pace. Wicked work, wicked work. Awesome. Keep the level of intensity going. After 5 seconds, we're gonna stop abruptly and we're gonna go into side planks. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Side planks, side planks. Make sure that the side that you are leaning on is not dipping down. Make sure it's solid, strong, tight. There we go. Brilliant work, awesome work. Hold yourself upright, hold yourself accountable for the next 5, 4, 3, 2. Change sides, change sides. Side plank, and we've got another 10 seconds holding that posture, holding that weight. Try to not allow your hips to dip. Keep this all nice and tight. 5, 4, 3, 2. We then sit back on the bench and then we go into glute bridging only. Glute bridging only. A slight dip. You can put your elbows on the bench, whatever you feel is right. All you're gonna be doing now is glute bridging at the top. Really feeling it, contracting, isolating, squeezing, holding, stomach, glutes, hamstrings, feeling it in the stabilizing parts of your body. Shoulders, biceps, triceps, forearms, wrists. Make sure that the feeling is dominant on the middle section of your body. We've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, round 3. beast of a round is done. Well done, well done. Right, next round, introducing core. So we will need the mats. Get your mats. You're going to put the mat on the floor and you're going to lie down on your back. You're going to lie down on your backs and the feet, the heels will be on the bench. So your legs will be 90 degree angle. Wrist. Hips, knee. Knee, ankle. And we are going to go into leg raises, but partial. So we are feeling it more in the stomach than we are feeling it in the hip flexors. So, on your back, get your heels on the bench, put your hands flat on the floor beside you at an angle so that you are stabilized. And in 3, 2, 1, you're gonna lift your knees right up to meet your shoulders. So your tailbone, your lower back is gonna lift off the ground. And then you are going to need discipline in order for you to control that lower back rolling back down so that your heels are not smashing into the bench, into the seat, into the sofa, whatever you guys are using to perform this abdominal core hip flexion movement. Keep this going for the next 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, place your heels on the bench and then cross your hands across your body so that your fingers are now lying on either side of your shoulders. And then lift your upper body up so that your shoulder blades are just about releasing themselves from the floor. And now you are crunching. Now you are crunching. We are not sitting up, we are crunching. If the neck hurts, then lace your fingers, place them behind your head, cushion your neck, and continue on the movement. When you continue on the movement, make sure that your chin is not dug in to your chest. There is always a gap between the chin and the chest. Abdominal crunches. After 5 seconds, you are going to release this movement. You're going to raise your legs up to the sky. You are going to point your fingers to your toes and you are going to crunch with another variation, version of the crunch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift your legs right up. Point your fingers to your toes and you are going to crunch, crunch, crunch. So you are now trying to reach your feet with your fingers. Even though that's not going to happen, that is the perception. Remember, just like the normal crunches that you did, only the shoulder blades are the parts of the body that will elevate off the ground. No more than that. Do not try to sit up. This is intentionally all about the stomach. And we've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna roll up. Roll over on our front, and we are gonna get in a plank position, and we're gonna hold the plank. Hold the plank, hold the plank. We're gonna hold the plank for 5 seconds. Sorry, 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, we're gonna put the knee on the floor, and we're gonna go into a tabletop momentarily, pausing so that we can then go into panther shoulder taps. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, put the knees down, reset yourself, get your hands underneath your shoulders, dig your toes into the ground, elevate your knees from the floor, and then start touching the shoulders. Opposite shoulder, tap, stomach, nice and tight. Your stomach will feel bruised around this moment in time because you have worked it so intentionally, so isolatingly, and we have shifted the body towards outstanding measures so it can perform to outstanding standards. We have got another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We are going to stand up. We are going to get weights. We are going to get weights. And we are going to go into full front raises. We're going to expand the stomach. Feel the stretch in the stomach. Hold the weights up in the sky. Hold them for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring them down slowly. Bring them down slowly. Bring them down slowly towards the front of the thigh. Don't touch the front of the thigh. And raise up again with a bit more momentum. We are now just going for reps. All about the reps. Front, full, raises, reps. There we go. Wicked work. Keep this going, everyone. Keep this going. We are going to give another 10 more seconds and we are going to call it for this round. We've got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Well done. Well done. Round 4 and final round coming up. Wicked work. And it's going to be a little bit of everything. So, catch your breaths, hydrate yourselves. We have got another 4 minutes left. So we have to be intentional. Intentional. All right then. We will start with the plates. We're gonna go into side lateral angled raises. Then we're gonna go into squats with the side lateral angled raises. Then we're gonna go into lunges, combining side lateral raises and bicep curls. Then we're gonna go into rear delts. And then we're gonna go into a plethora of other movements. So everything will be short, sharp, quick, intense as hell. When you are ready, we will go side lateral angled raise. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We go. Side lateral angle raise. When you're bringing the plates down, do not tap them on your thighs. When you are bringing them up, make sure that they are shoulder height. After 5 seconds, you are going to pause the weights shoulder height and you are going to combine a squat. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold the weights up, squat. Come up, side lateral raise, hold the weight up, squat. Side lateral raise, hold the weight up, squat. Wicked, wicked work. 5 seconds, we are gonna go unilateral. One leg at a time, lunging. Just normal, having the weight either side of our body, letting the blood flow and settle. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dumbbells by the side, one leg only, unilateral lunges. Feeling that blood proper circulate around the arms, going around the chest, down into that stomach, around the hips, and then being introduced to the quadriceps, the hamstrings, the glutes, and we are gonna swap the legs in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We swap the legs, unilateral, unilateral. Swap the legs, wicked work. Now, in 10 seconds, we're gonna alternate the legs again. But this time round, every time that we lunge with one leg, we're gonna side lateral raise. Then we're gonna alternate the legs and we're gonna bicep curl whilst we are in the lunge position. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We lunge, we side lateral raise. We come up, we lunge with the other leg, we bicep curl, we go back, and we repeat the sequence of lunging, alternate lunging, and alternate movements, upper body. One movement is bicep curl. The other movement is side lateral raise. And we are gonna quit that in 10 seconds time. We're gonna stand tall, stand fast, stand strong. We're gonna bend ourselves over, and we're gonna go into a rear delt raise. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna stand up tall, hip hinge, bring the plates down to the front, and we are going to rear delt raise. Every time you raise the dumbbells or the plate that you have in your hands, make sure your thumbs are pointing to the front. They are not pointing up, they can be pointing down. It's all about getting the rear delt to agree with this movement as you perform a rear shoulder raise, working rear shoulder, triceps, traps, stomach, lats, and we have hip flexors to help us become stable, hamstrings to help us become stable, and in 5 seconds we're going to get back up and we're going to combine side lateral, front raise, rear delt, all together. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, we go. Side lateral, front raise, hip hinge, rear delt. Stand up, side lateral, front raise, bend yourselves over, rear delt. Side lateral, front raise, bend yourselves over, rear delt. Wicked work. Another 5 seconds, dropping the dumbbells, plates, going into a little jog. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop, 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 and we go into a little jog. Little jog, little jog. In 5 seconds, side lunge. 5 seconds, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Side lunge, come to the middle, side lunge. Come to the middle, side lunge. Wicked, come to the middle, side lunge. Brilliant work. When you now go to the middle, we're gonna go into tuck jumps. Middle, tuck jumps, side lunge. That's it, there we go. Side lunge, tuck jumps, side lunge, tuck jumps. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, jog in the spot, jog in the spot, jog in the spot, and 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Well done, everyone. Oh, hello, hello. Well done, well done. Right, if you've got a couple of minutes, small bit of mobilization, small bit of cool down. I'm not gonna change the music because that is far too much of a fuss. So what we are gonna do is just calm it all down now and get yourself into space, safe space, raise your arms right up in the air, make your spine very, very tall. If you want to lean back, please feel free to do so because you are now going into the supine stretch. From the supine stretch, we are going to bring our arms back down to our sides in a semicircle fashion. But before we do that, we're going to take a deep breath in through the nose. When we breathe in, we're going to feel our belly rise, not our shoulders. We're going to concentrate on breathing from our midsection. When you are ready, take a deep breath in through the nose. Now, get to the end of that breath and then release the breath. You can make it vocal. And as you release the breath, the arms are going down either side of the body, all the way down to the front. And then you're going to hip hinge and travel your hands down the thigh, over the knee, down the shin, all the way through, all the way down to the toes. Place your fingers on the floor if you can. If you cannot, flex your knees, round your back, and then walk your fingers out to the point where you can go flat with your hands, and then try to make sure your heels are also flat to the floor. So now you are in the downward facing dog. You're gonna raise one leg up in the air really strong, really tight, hold. We're now in the three-legged dog. That leg that is extended, you're gonna fold it at the knee. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna rotate your hips and you're gonna stack your hips, one on top of the other, by rotating your midsection. So we are stacking the hips. You're then gonna release that stack, place your foot down, feel the blood flow, and then you are going to complement by lifting the other leg up. So it's all equal. Fold at the knee, and then you're gonna twist at the midsection, stack your hips. Nice oblique stretch, holding it, feeling it in the shoulders, returning back to the beginning, and then dropping your fingers on the floor so you've got a nice tripod stance. Walk your feet to your hands, slide your fingers up your feet, slide your fingers up your shin, over the knee, up the thigh, release the hands from the body, reverse semicircle all the way up, back to the very, very beginning of the posture that you started this stretching part with. And then again, deep breath in, and then as you allow the air to escape, your arms go down to your side. And well freaking done, everyone. Ladies and gents, everyone on Insta, and thanking you. We are out.